We have martial arts in Ukraine. If you did not know about this, then stay with us and we will tell you. I'm not going to tell you, but our guest, Yuri Kostrov, who came to us from the capital in order to talk about his martial art, which he created in Ukraine. Yuri Kostrov, Grandmaster, Professor, Kaiso and Meijin, 10th Baser, Dan Agni Kempo. Creator of Agni Kempo martial art and founder of the World Agni Kempo Organization. He was born in 1950. Professional trainer for him at Agni Kempo. The main thing is the survival and health of those who have joined his style. However, he does not want to engage in fights without rules and forbids his students. He thinks that taking part in him is unworthy of his students and him as a master. We need to start with a story. The history of fist fighting is very long, as is the history of our country. Various sources say that the history of martial arts began in India and China. But I dispute such allegations. Since I delved into a large layer of historical literature which says that in very ancient times, thousands of years ago, in the north of India there was a country, Aryana, in which our ancestors lived and who were called Aryans. The Aryans already had their own, very strong, martial art. You told me that there are sports fights, and there is martial art. And that these are completely different ways. It's true, yes, this one is like that. This significant difference is very simple. I myself, in the past, are a professional athlete and we were taught to achieve victory at any cost over my opponent. However, in martial art, first of all, one must triumph over oneself. The ancient philosophers said, "He who can defeat himself cannot be defeated." Please tell us about your Agni Kempo martial art. What it is, according to the historical names of our cities. We can judge what kind of love and respect people enjoyed fist fights. For example, near Kiev there are two small towns, which are called Butcher and Bukhanka, respectively. From the ancient Slavic language, these names are translated as fight and little fight. According to legend, competitions were held in Butcher between old masters and in Bukhanka, youth tournaments. By the way, we have the city of Bukhik in the Ternopil region. You see, all these are echoes of the love of our people for their martial arts. As for the style of Agni Kempo that I created, it was conceived and implemented as a powerful combat system and, at the same time, as a universal martial art. Therefore, in my system there is a diverse technique of striking hands and feet, a variety of throwing techniques, working with a variety of weapons, both with old Slavonic and Eastern, as well as modern cold steel and firearms. This is a very large layer of knowledge and it takes the many years of training to master it. Also, in Agni Kempo there are special techniques to suppress aggression. They can be both tactile and non-tactile. These are our features and secrets. This knowledge is so dangerous that in my school I teach it only to those students who have achieved a high level of training, including moral, and who will never change this knowledge to harm an ordinary, civilian person. Such knowledge is received only by instructors, as well as those of my students who have been with me for at least 10 years. Mr. Yuri, I think that to create your own style you need to have extensive knowledge about other types of martial arts in order to be able to correctly select the best and most necessary from them. How did you come to this? As I told you earlier, I started doing martial arts at the age of 10 and am already on this way for 44 years. I studied many arts, boxing, sambo, judo, shotokan karate, Goju-Ryu Karate, Kyokushinkai Karate, Kung Fu Shang Dao Quan, which was given to me by my last teacher. Therefore, of course, I created my martial arts system on the basis of my existing knowledge. It is impossible without this. However, there are times when I cannot convey in words where and how this knowledge comes to me. Therefore, I am cautious and critical of the phrase, creator of something. God created everything, and we can only be the founders of something. Here is an example, R. Lestwitzer. Lestwitzer's formal exercises like kata in karate, pumsa in taekwondo, or tao in wushu. Lestwitzer is an old Slavonic name and means a ladder or step, as a level of mastery. That is, studying Lestwitzer's, the student with each of its new forms moves to a different, higher level. That Lestwitzer's are the tool with which we can pass on our style of Agni Kenpo from generation to generation. However, all the Lestwitzer's were given to me immediately and as a whole. I just wrote them down and scratched. You can say that you were given information, like at a poet, for example. Yes, I could say that. This happens only at the moment of inspiration by a certain muse. Please tell us about the full contact fights that your organization has. In general, the correct name for the battles in our system is acute contact or full penetrating contact. By the way, it was thanks to our style of Agni Kenpo that the term full penetrating contact was introduced into the world of martial arts. The fights in our system are very realistic. We do not use any protectors to protect the body, except for the groin in men and bibs in women. Tell me, what your weight categories and do your men and women compete in mixed pairs? When Agni Kenpo was created, we did not have weight categories. All competitions were held as an absolute championship, without restrictions. However, later, we created the following weight categories. Minus 55 kilograms, minus 65 kilograms, minus 75 kilograms, minus 85 kilograms to 95 kilograms and plus 95 kilogram. However, according to our tradition, we conduct all championships according to weight categories, and all cup tournaments are absolute, that is, without weight categories. Now, let's sort the video. What are they talking about? These are our performances in South Korea and the autumn tournament in Kiev, where we defeated the Kyokushinkai Karate Federation. Let's, we watching Agni Kenpo. You are watching our program and today we are talking about Agni Kenpo. Mr. Yuri, you are a teacher for your students. Tell me, at what age can come to study Agni Campo? At the end of the 80s. We recruited students starting from the age of 12, since at that time we did not yet have the necessary methods. But over time, we improved on old methods and created new ones. And now in our clubs, in different cities of Ukraine, we are recruiting children from the age of 5. And as in ancient times, such a child by the age of 12 becomes a full-fledged warrior. Tell me, in Agni Campo, in addition to martial art, is there a sports direction? In Agni Campo there are certain canons and there are sports rules for a duel. In general, we have 7 rules for competitions. From children's to professional, from simple to complex, we do not have the so-called free fight, as they say now, fights without rules. This is just an advertising ploy. There are still rules there. You cannot drink in the groin, spine, throat and eyes, for example. This is exactly what is the basis of any martial art, as a survival system. And fighting without rules is just a business, entertainment for the sake of money. While here, someone earns a lot of money, while someone loses their health. I think it's not equivalent. This is my opinion, but everyone makes his own choice. I will give an example. What else is the difference? For sports competitions, you do not need to learn 12 blocks with the hands that are in Agni Campo. To do this, it is enough to know 3 or 4 blocks. The same with the technique of blows. There is no spiritual, philosophical basis in such battles, except for the selfish one, to rise to first place on the podium. That is, it cannot be called martial art. This is a sport. In real martial art there is no selfishness. Therefore, performance in such competitions is unworthy of a man and a master. By the way, I conducted an analysis of the participants and coaches of these tournaments. I did not see a single serious trainer and master fighter. In the end, I want to say that it is impossible to risk your health and life for the sake of dubious successes and money. You can risk your own life for the sake of your family, for the people around you who are in danger, for the sake of the fatherland. It is worthy of a fighter and warrior. Take any promoter of fights without rules and you will understand that they did not take part in competitions. They don't know what a real blow is. But they know how to count well and make money from someone else's health. What competitions do you have? What tournaments do your students take part in? Agni Campo is a style of full penetrating contact and is as close to reality as possible. However, we have competition rules that remove any negative consequences. Also, we take part in competitions of quite rigid martial arts styles. For example, these are styles like Kyokushinkai Karate, Ashihara Karate, Vovinam Viet Vodau and the like. Now in the world there are not many such styles. We live in a different time and people are no longer looking for real martial arts. People are more inclined to search for exotic, beautiful clothes with a black belt, recreation or knowledge about another culture. Unfortunately, true martial arts are now dying out and becoming a business. But not Agni Campo, therefore. Since 1992, we have had some success and growth. That year, at the International Ashihara Karate Tournament in Moscow, we were the first. Then, in 1993, in the Kiev Palace of Sports, we defeated representatives from 5 countries who put up more than 20 styles of different martial arts against us. Although at that time my students had only red belts, and their rivals had black belts. In 1997, my student participated in the Kyokushinkai Karate World Championship and took 6th place, entering the 8 of the strongest fighters in the world. In 2000, 2 of my students became world average and super heavyweight champions in Ashihara Karate. And in the same championship, 2 more of my students became the second in light and heavyweight. In 2001, Bulgaria hosted our first World Agni Kempo Cup. 10 teams from almost all continents took part in it. This cup was held on two divisions. The division of junior or colored belts and the division of senior or black belts. In both divisions our fighters were the first. So we have good worthy successors. It is joyful when our guys rise to the highest step of the podium and the anthem of Ukraine sounds. We continue our talk about martial arts. Each person should have a strong psyche and good health. Is there a healing aspect to Agni Kempo? Of course. In general, Agni Kempo is developing in six directions. For this in our martial art there are six subsystems or methods. The first is the young fighter. The second, junior. The third, the wellness system, bridge with elements of self-defense. The fourth area is professional. This is survival and self-defense for civilians. Fifth, Puma, this is for the police, border guards and customs. The sixth direction, BARS, a training system for special forces of the army, navy, security services and secret services. Tell us how anyone can get to you. Do you have any sort of selection in groups? Every year we define for ourselves the concept of development, including some promotional events, posters and posters. Performances on television and in secondary schools, demonstrations during the holidays, etc. However, this does not mean that we accept everyone in our groups, without exception. We have some testing methods. For example, when the list of newcomers is completed, our psychologist begins to work with them and identifies those people who have psychological deviations that are unnecessary for us. Of course, such people do not come to us, because during the training process, our students receive in their hands such knowledge that is a weapon. In general, each of our students, after a certain period of study, becomes a weapon himself. Therefore, we care about who, how and where will use our knowledge. Have you or your students ever had to use their Agni Kempo skills? The time of criminal groups that included athletes of different types of wrestling has already passed. In the dashing 90s, I was invited to train criminal groups. I gave up such a career. I have completely different values and goals. In general, correctly educated in martial arts, a person calculates his steps several steps forward and circumvents all dangerous situations. This is not because he is afraid of, for example, a street fight, but because he can cause very serious injuries and incur criminal responsibility for this. At least in our country. Now I understand why your school needs such a test for admission to the group. Well, apart from the test, natural processes and students drop out. For example, those who cannot submit to our requirements and discipline are the first to filter out from our groups. The second to leave our groups are some people for family or work reasons. Still others who leave us are those who at a certain moment could not overcome the fear of difficulties and pain. But there was, fortunately, in my entire coaching life, there were three or four people. That is, does pain still exist in your training process? Not. This is not a correct statement of the question. Pain does not exist at all. She is only in our minds. In the brain, and some people are not able to overcome this psychological frontier. Is it possible to use the methods of Agni Kanpo in law enforcement agencies? Yes, it is possible. However, from the very beginning of the development of our style in Ukraine, the power structures did not pay attention to us. Since for their preparation there were old methods of hand-to-hand combat and combat sambo. But in our groups, and I have personally, some guys from special forces, such as Falcon, Golden Eagle and Titan, trained. I trained them with pleasure. However, other countries became interested in us, who saw in our speeches some useful information for them. For this reason, I conducted several training seminars for special forces in Bulgaria, Morocco, Canada, and South Korea. But I do not share the secrets of our style to anyone. All the secrets of the methodical, technical and spiritual preparation of Agni Kanpo are given only to the adherents of our style, those who really promote it, both in our country and abroad. This is only for verified students, family members, and the Agni Kanpo clan. I know that an important event has recently taken place in your organization. Your student has passed some incredible tests that only a real fighter can do. Tell us about it. Which test is this? I did not come up with this test but took it from the great masters of the past. This test very well reveals the best and worst sides of a fighter in his physical, technical and psychological preparation. Such a test was carried out in ancient Japan. For example, at the Hokusanitoru Sword Fencing School, Master Yamuro Kateshu held 100 fights without stopping. However, not on real swords, but on bamboo shinai, but he won all the fights. The second one to pass such a test was the outstanding Japanese judoka of all time Masahiko Kimura, who spent 200 fights without stopping over 2 days, according to the old judo rules, and won all fights. After this event, a saying was born in Japan: before Kimura, there was no Kimura, after Kimura, there will no Kimura. The great master and founder of Kyokushin Kai Karate, Oyama Masatatsu, was very interested in this test when he was still young. He gathered the best students in his dojo and within 3 days he had 300 fights. The legend says that when on the fourth day he wanted to continue the test, all his students refused this, as they had great damage. Oyama did not win all the fights but passed the test to the end. There is such an international list that includes outstanding fighters of the world of the 20th century, and I am very glad that three of my students were included in it. During the 20th century, only 14 fighters managed to complete 100 fights without stopping, and 13 people completed 50 fights. In 1993, my student Yuri Bruenko spent 50 fights without stopping in full contact and became the 14th person on this list. Then, in 2003, the student of my student, the head of the Chernihiv branch Bogdan Rapatsky, Eugene Budas, also passed the difficult test and became the 20th in the international list. And this year, at the summer school, my student Yuri Labziak repeated a similar feat. At first he passed the technical exam to obtain the next master's degree, which lasted 6 hours, and the next day he passed 50 fights in full contact, without stopping. He became the 21st in the international list of the best fighters on the planet. For Ukraine, this is a mega event, since in Ukraine we are the only organization that did this. I heard that you also do charity work. It's true, we are not a charitable organization. However, we accept in our ranks children from dysfunctional families, half orphans, orphans. It is difficult for them in this world and therefore we help him as much as we can. For example, they have significant discounts or receive our knowledge for free. Also, they receive all uniforms and special equipment for free.